This class we work out four problems. First problem is a power station has the daily load curve given below in the table. This is the time the load is given. Find the following curves. Number one, load duration curve. Number two, load curve. Number three, load energy curve. Number four, load factor. Number five, utilization factor. First, we draw the load duration curve. Here 6 p.m. to 12 night, 80 megawatt. So this is 80 megawatt. Next is 60 megawatt and 50, 30, 20. Okay. From the load duration curve, we can easily calculate unit generated per day. That is equal to area of the load duration curve. Area is equal to, this is 80 into 6 plus 60 into 9.5 plus 50 into 0.5 plus 30 into 2 plus 20 into 6. So unit generated per day is equal to 1255 megawatt hour. Next we draw the load curve. This is the load curve. The next question is calculate the load factor. Daily load factor is equal to unit generated per day divided by maximum demand into 24. From the load duration curve, we know the maximum demand. Maximum demand is 80 megawatts. Unit generated per day is 1255 by maximum demand, 80 into 24. Daily load factor is equal to 0.65 or 65%. Here the plant installed capacity is given 100 megawatts. So we can easily calculate utilization factor. Utilization factor is equal to maximum demand divided by installed capacity. Maximum demand is 80, installed capacity is 100. 80 by 100 is equal to 0.8. Next we have to draw the load energy curve. X axis load in megawatts, Y axis energy in megawatt hour. So from the load duration curve, we have to calculate the area. This is A1, A2, A3, A4, A5. So five areas we have to calculate. First at load, this is in load, this is energy, this is area, that is point P1. Here load in 20 megawatts, 20 into 24, this area. 20 into 24 is equal to 480, area is 480. This point is P1, at 20 megawatts, this is P1. The next is, we have to calculate this area. This is 10 into 18. 10 into 18 is 180. 180 plus 460, that is equal to 660. This is a point P2. At 30 megawatt, this point is P2. The third is, we have to calculate this area. This is 20 into 16. 20 into 16 is equal to 320 plus 660, that is equal to 980. So 50 megawatts, point P3, this is 980. Next is this area, 10 into 15.5, that is equal to 155 plus 980, that is equal to 1135, this point is P4. At 16 megawatts, this energy is P4, P4 is 1135. Last is this area, this is 20 into 6, that is 120, 120 plus 1135, that is equal to 1255, this point is P5. At 80, this point is P5. This curve is called as load energy curve. This way you have to work on this problem. Second problem, the daily demands of three consumers are given below in the table. This is time, consumer 1, consumer 2, consumer 3. The question is plot the load curve. Second question is maximum demand of individual consumers. Third question is load factor of individual consumers. Fourth is diversity factor. Fifth is load factor of the station. So we have to draw the load curve. This is the load curve. From the load curve, we can easily find the maximum demand of the station. That is 2700 watts. At 2 to 4 p.m., 300 plus 1100 plus 1300, that is equal to 2700, that is the maximum demand on the station. Next we have to calculate unit generated per day of consumer 1. So 12 midnight to 8 a.m. there is no load. So 8 a.m. to 2 p.m., 700 into 6, plus 2 p.m. to 4 p.m., 2 into 300, plus 4 p.m. to 10 p.m., 900 into 6, that is equal to 10,200 watts. So 10 p.m. to midnight, there is no load. Similarly, unit generator per day of consumer 2, 300 into 8, plus 1,100 into 2, plus 300 into 2, that is equal to 5,200 watts. Units generated per day of consumer 3, that is 300 into 6, plus 1,300 into 2, plus 300 into 2, that is equal to 5,000 watts. So we know the units generated per day of consumer 1, consumer 2 and consumer 3. Now we can easily calculate the load factor. Load factor is equal to unit generated per day divided by maximum demand into 24. Maximum demand of individual consumers. So maximum demand of consumer 1 is 900 watts. Maximum demand of consumer 2 is 1100 watts. Maximum demand of consumer 3 is 1300 watts. So consumer 1 load factor is 10,200 divided by 900 into 24, that is equal to 0.47 or 47%. Similarly, load factor of consumer 2 is equal to 5200 divided by 1100 into 24, 0.196 or 19.6%. Consumer 3, the unit generated per day is 5000 divided by 1300 into 24, that is equal to 0.16 or 16%. The next is diversity factor. Diversity factor is equal to sum of the individual maximum demand divided by maximum demand of the station. So maximum demand of consumer 1, consumer 2, consumer 3, 900 plus 1100 plus 1300 divided by 2700. 2700 is the station maximum demand, that is equal to 1.2, that is a diversity factor. Station load factor is equal to unit generated per day, that is 10,200 plus 5,200 plus 5,000 divided by maximum demand of the station into 24. Maximum demand is 2,700 into 24. That is 10,200 plus 5,200 plus 5,000 divided by 2,700 into 24. That is equal to 0.31 or 31%. Third problem, the power station has to meet the following demand. This is time in hours. This is group 1. This is group 2. This is group 3. This is group 4. The question is plot the load curve. Second question is unit generated per day. Third question is diversity factor. Fourth is load factor. First we calculate the total load on power station. For the 0 to 6 hours, that is 100 kilowatts. 6 to 8 hours, 275 kilowatts. 8 to 10 hours, 575 kilowatts. 10 to 18, 500 kilowatts. 8 to 24, 200 kilowatts. From this we can easily calculate the maximum demand of the power station. Maximum demand of the power station is 575 kilowatts. Next we calculate unit generated per day, that is equal to 100 into 6 plus 275 into 2 plus 575 into 2 plus 500 into 8 plus 200 into 6, that is equal to 5700 kilowatt hour. That is unit generated per day. Next we can calculate average load. Average load is equal to unit generated per day divided by 24. 5700 by 24, that is equal to 237.5 kilowatts. That is the average load. Next we can calculate load factor. Load factor is equal to average load divided by maximum demand of the station. Average load is 237.5, maximum demand of the station is 575. 237.5 divided by 575, that is equal to 0.41 or 41%. So this is the load curve. Here this is 100 kilowatts, this is 275, this is 575, 500, 200. Load curve. Last problem, a central station is supplying energy to a community through two substations. Each substation feeds four feeders. This is feeder 1, feeder 2, feeder 3, feeder 4. Two substations. Substation A 6000 kilowatts, substation B 9000 kilowatts. The maximum demand, daily recorded demands are, power station is 12,000 kilowatts. These are all the data, feeder 1, feeder 2, feeder 3, feeder 4. The question is calculate the diversity factor between the substations. Number 2, feeders on substation. Number 3, feeders on substation B. Substation A, substation B. First we calculate diversity factor of the substation. So the maximum demand is 6000 plus 9000, that is equal to 15000. 15000 maximum demand of the power station is 12000. So 15000 by 12000, that is equal to 1.25. next, the diversity factor of the substation A. Here 1700 plus 1800 plus 2800 plus 600 divided by maximum demand of the substation A, 6000, that is equal to 1.15. The next is diversity factor of the substation B. Substation B is, that is feeder 1, 2820 plus 1500 plus 4000 plus 2900 divided by substation B maximum demand is 9000, that is equal to 1.25. This is where you have to work out this problem. Thanks for listening.